welcome to Ground Zero, where we bring you your weekly dose of citizen journalism. This is Sarah, and I'm Clarissa.
Hello, everyone, and hey, Clarissa. Mm-hmm. Have you had any unpleasant experiences with cab drivers before?
No, not really. I think I've been quite lucky to get nice cabbies most of the time.
Well, a friend of Stumper Icy Greenkey was not so lucky because his cabbie drove off with his iPad and bag when he got off to send his girlfriend to the lift.
Oh man, well, didn't the cabbie know that he was going to come back?
Yes, he did, apparently. The girlfriend of the Stomper's friend said in a Facebook post that they had yet to pay the $18 fare and that the driver was aware that her boyfriend had left his belongings in his taxi because he had turned to look when he alighted from the cab.
And Icy Green Tea also added that he left his stuff for fear of being accused of not paying, but when he got back, he was horrified to discover that the cab had driven off with his iPad and his bag. Well, it looks like he trusted the cabbie a bit too much.
Hopefully, he'll get his valuables back soon, as he made a police report an hour after the incident. Stomper Eagle offered some words of advice, saying that the passenger was being too careless, and next time, tell driver to follow you, law.
And traffic analyst 66 offered a different point of view, saying the taxi driver is smart. He drives off with an iPad and other valuables to sacrifice the $18 cab fare he's supposed to earn for this trip. He also added that he should leave his IC instead of these items, and now it's too late already.
Moving on, Stomper Desmond was appalled when his cabbie charged him $50 for a trip when his son vomited in a taxi.
Well, Desmond explained, halfway through the journey, my 2-year-old son vomited, and the taxi driver did not even care, and he said that we had to pay $50 for the car wash. And to make matters worse, he also sent us to the wrong place. And when we got out of the taxi and asked for the receipt, he slowly tried to find it again and again. While Desmond feels that this cabbie should have been more empathetic, but some Stompers were quick to defend the driver.
Ling Ling, MCF, said, "Stomper, you have to pay more. The stink or smell, the lost hours needed to clean, pay $50 already, very kind to you."
Saw to the Sky agreed and said that even if the taxi driver gave empathy to the Stomper, who could give the driver empathy for the lost income and the stench? He encouraged Desmond to be more gracious and generous, adding, "If it is your car and someone throws up, you will be spending time and money cleaning up too, right?"
Yeah, I agree with what Ling Ling and Saw to the Sky said. The Stomper should have offered the driver some form of compensation for the time and effort spent in cleaning up the taxi.
Moving on, Stomper Jessie tells us about her own unpleasant experience with a nightmare cabbie who she claims assaulted her after she alighted.
She wrote, "On the date of November 28, in the early morning when I was driven home by a taxi driver, he assaulted me. I remember on the way home to Yishun, the driver and I did not have any communication. When I reached my house car park and I paid the cab fare, he suddenly slapped me on my right cheek. I quickly got out of the cab and he too got down, and I quickly backed to the middle of the road in the car park and he started to assault me and tried to drag me over."
Jessie's father came to the rescue when he heard her screams, but the cabbie had already driven off. She describes him as a plump Chinese man in his late 30s to early 40s and warns girls in Singapore to be careful and alert when taking cabs.
That must have been really scary, especially if the attack was unprovoked.
Well, another Stomper commented that this is a one-sided story and I seriously can't bring myself to believe that the driver would hit you for no apparent reason. And something must have happened and you did not stomp here, unless the taxi driver is really a nutbag.
Storm Chaser asked to keep us posted of the outcome after police investigation. If not, this is just a makeup story.
Well, I do feel that there is something really suspicious here, and I don't think the cabbie would have hit the Stomper unprovoked unless he really is a nightmare cabbie. Next up, we find out more about how bad service attitudes leave customers with a bad taste in their mouth.
Stay with us.